This is C&S Farms. We also have a division known as C Farms Logistics and Distribution. That's a brand new trucking outfit that we're getting off the ground right now. Here on the farm, we have about 500 acres. We split up pretty close to half and half. We do half row crop and half hay. We're nestled in the heart of the Brushy Mountains in North Carolina. We plant rye, corn, and soybeans. And like I said, we do hay. So we'll overseed and drill fescue. We harvest either corn and soybeans. Sometimes we'll rotate those around. We don't always do corn or always do soybeans, but we always do rye and we always do hay. My name is Mac. I'm the operations manager. These folks call me the walking boss. I get the word from Chuck, the owner, and make sure that it gets done regardless. So. We're glad to have you. We hope we do something interesting that y'all are gonna enjoy. But more importantly, we're just here for the comedy of it. We've had such a great time doing this over the years that we thought we'd bring y'all along and let y'all enjoy it too. I'm gonna let these gentlemen beside me introduce themselves, tell you what they do, and we're happy to have you.
My name's Jamie Welburn, and I'm kind of Mac's right-hand man. I'm the second in charge on the farming operations thing. I just do whatever Mac tells me to do and make sure that it gets done.
My name is Eric Francis. I'm the shop foreman here at C&S Farms. I can take all the quiz. Hope you enjoy it.
You hang out with us. We're gonna be bringing y'all some videos of everything from harvesting to planting to spraying and fertilizing.
Heating and beating.
Mechanicking with Aaron. Farming with Jamie. Trucking, whatever we can record, we're going to record it. Hope y'all enjoy it. Like I said, we're glad to have you. Be sure to go down in the comments, tell us what you think. If you like it, tell us. If you don't like it, tell us. We'll try to make sure that we're doing everything okay. And if you have comments on the videoing, like the producing aspect, please let us know because we're brand new to this too. So just drop us a good word. Today is December the 9th. About 3:45 in the afternoon, and today we're planting a little rye. Got our 6140R picked up to our 15-foot grain drill, and we're in what Chuck calls the pig field. Gonna see if we can get it planted before quitting time. Y'all come with us. We're using the auto steering feature, so all I have to do is just sit here and make sure the tractor doesn't lose its mind. This is about a 33-35 acre field, something like that. And like I said, Chuck calls it the pig field. He's given all our fields names. I don't know where he gets them from. Maybe he could tell you that, but anyhow, I'm just riding around, not doing much. A lot of people like to plant rye in their cornfields as a cover crop. And we actually harvest the rye and use it as we sell it to a distillery locally here. And then we'll come back with either a short span corn or soybeans in the fall. So this will be ready to harvest, hopefully, end of July, or end of June, 1st of July. And we'll be able to come right behind that with corn or soybeans. Keep the whole process rolling. All right, we're coming up on 3 complete laps. What we're gonna do, we're gonna stop right up here, check things out, make sure we still got seed, and make sure everything's still planting right. I think we're gonna be in for a beautiful sunset back there. So, still got plenty of good rye seed in there. That's what we're planting. And we'll come around here and pull our corn stalks out. Make sure there ain't no seed spilling out of the top of our tubes. Make sure none of our tubes are stopped up. Everything looked good. Get back after it. Look, coming there. It's seed delivery. Catch them on the... When we end this lap, we'll be back right there at the road where they're gonna come in. We'll get refilled. Yeah, but it won't. Okay. I'm back. Not only do we get seed, we get a chauffeur. You know, riding around in a tractor with nothing to do but let your mind wander. Just thinking, I believe it was 2 or 3 years ago, I was doing the same thing, except I was in a 6430, I believe it was, with a 10 or 12 foot grain drill we was using at the time. Come down through this bottom right here that we're going into now. Somewhere about the same place we are now, maybe a little further towards that big curve, I found a humongous mud hole and sunk that witch right down to the axis. We dug and dug and pulled and like never got the blasted thing out of here. Now this year it's so dusty I can hardly see it in the mirrors behind me. It's 38 degrees and it ain't rained in over a week, I guess. Of course, the weather up here on top of the big, beautiful, brushy mountains is always crazy anyway. You never know what you're gonna get. Beautiful day.
Clambering up through there.
That thing's like a trampoline on top of it. You can jump for days. Oh, Lord, hold on. Mind that, folks. A little turbulence here.
Get up there. You get the thing stuck up there, and they got nothing to fasten it with. So he goes there and gets one of them bands off that and suck up stuff.
And we self-tapped it to the gutter to hold it. It's still kind of leaning forward, but it's not flopping left or right anymore. Well, he said, I'm going to seal that crack up around there. I said, I don't believe I'd do it with that stuff. Oh, yeah, I'll be fine. I said, you better get a glove. No, I'll be fine. He takes him a handful of that stuff and starts globbing it. And then it's stuck to him. And by the time he gets off roof, his fingers just froze solid. he can't move his hand.
I was wondering.
I come back in, he's got brake clear and everything, trying to spray it and wipe it off with rags. It's just running everywhere. Tried to wash it off with water, it wouldn't come off. That's why it's a tickle to be called a lot.
Couldn't
help it.
Funny.
Right on. Move your phone. Mash number two. Yeah, turn the backlights on too. I think that's it.
Should we tell them what we purchased today, or should we wait till it gets here?
Nah, go ahead and tell them, Mac. Tell them what they won, Mac.
You tell them.
Sales behind door number two.
Coming home with us first thing Monday, which will be 3 more days. We're going up to Mount Airy, North Carolina, to bring home a Kenworth T800.
Right. Yep, 400 get, 8LL. Tribes.
White with a red top and red fenders.
More maroon, really.
Maroon. Whatever. Black, bed.
It's metallic, too.
It is metallic. It's sparkly. Looks kind of like a bass boat.
Yeah.
Anyhow, we're pretty excited about it.
Heat up. This is my excited face.
Well, I aim to have hauling services into our farming operation. So if you are nearby and need anything hauled with a dump truck, contact us on Facebook, Instagram, right here on YouTube, and we'll hook you up.
Yeah, with us being agriculture, it should be galloping.
Yeah. What he said. Y'all.
Y'all too.
Yinz's.
Yinz too.
Yinz too. That's it. We will try to keep our videos family friendly for all ages. Sometimes we get a little fired up.
It gets a little western.
We'll do our best. If you hear something you don't like, we'll try to bleep it out.
Totally.
We're not exactly what you'd call good influences, but we're not bad influences either, so.
Just the influences.
Yeah, that's a pretty big leap there. Every video we make is going to start with, don't try this at home.
Yeah. You think this looks like a good idea, you're wrong.
Sometimes when the auto steer gets acting crazy like that, You just grab a hold of it and straighten her out yourself. Then in a minute, your little auto steer line will come back up and you mash your butt.
There's the tape again.
And back at it we go. Sun's about set now and it's 34 degrees, so it's dropped 4 degrees in 30 minutes.
Well, a little bit turbulence here.
I don't want to, but.
Now, whoever wrote the song Rocky Top?
The bold-faced liar. If you plant corn on a rock, in a rock, around a rock, it don't matter.
Right, there ain't never been dirt too rocky for corn to grow.
I'm fairly certain. Every year we fertilize these fields, the rocks get bigger. Every time we pick the rocks up, next year there's more rocks.
That's also true.
Like we're growing.
The heck of a quarry we got here.
I get another bunch of stuff. I ran low.
I know that stuff wanders away.
Fuel light was on.
On what?
On the backer pouch.
Oh.
It's play number 13.
Woo!
Doing it to it like Pruitt used to do it to it, like Pruitt was doing it to it, nobody do it.
Sorry, Jamie, for all the editing.
We love you, though. You're the favorite of the triplets.
Things we do for film around here. Maybe it's getting a little dark to film, and you've already seen us take 5 million laps around doing the same thing.
Yeah.
We're going to end this. I don't know if it's going to be a whole video or if it's going to end up being just a part of a video, but we're going to end this.
Either way, it's going to be a video.
That's right. We're going to end it right here, whatever it is. So, Aaron and Mike are signing out. We'll see you next time.
Lord willing, the creek don't rise.
That's right.